Computerized cognitive testing assists doctors in making return-to-play decisions for athletes. However, this is not a standalone tool.
It was very important from the concussion program standpoint to develop a consensus statement for the role of impact testing in the management of concussions, realizing that it's not the only neurocognitive test out there. We wanted to make sure that we understood that it has a role in our program, but it's not the only role in our program, and recognize that other specialties also use other neurocognitive exams.
The following points are important to note when using computerized cognitive tests to manage concussed patients. The role of computerized cognitive tests in the management of concussion has not been fully established. These tests may be used as an ancillary to assess the degree of cognitive impairment following a concussion. These tests may be used as an ancillary to monitor progression, improvement, or deterioration following a concussion. Computerized cognitive tests are most commonly used in athletes, especially when baseline testing was done prior to the concussion. These tests are not mandatory for managing patients who have sustained a concussion. These tests are not a substitute for the initial or subsequent clinical evaluations of patients who have sustained a concussion.
Impact test, it stands for the Immediate Post-Concussion Assessment and Cognitive Testing Tool. It is the first and most widely used and clinically validated computerized testing program that's used for concussion. The benefit of it is it's computer-based. In the past, when an athlete would get concussed, they would go see a neuropsychologist that would perform the traditional pencil and paper test. It took a couple hours to do. It was time consuming and it was very costly. But now with the implementation of a computer-based test, literally if there's enough computers in a computer lab, an entire team can be tested in a very short period of time. With the traditional neuropsychological testing, again, that was best done by a neuropsychologist, which is a psychologist trained in behavior and how the brain works. With the neuropsych testing that's computer-based, such as Impact, it's much easier that athletic trainers, physician assistants, nurses, and team physicians, primary care doctors, they can be trained in interpreting these tests. Now, if there's some subtle changes, if there's some complications, then oftentimes we get the help from a neuropsychologist. But in terms of getting things started and being able to kind of go through a baseline test and a basic post-injury test, that the primary care physicians can do very well with this. The baseline testing is important to have because it kind of gives us an idea of how that individual child's brain was functioning before the injury. But if they don't have access to a baseline test, or if they get concussed before they get a baseline, that's okay, because we can still use their scores and compare them to what we call age-matched norms. There's a whole database that they developed while developing the software, where there's boys and girls ages 10 to 18 that have taken the test. These are kids that don't have ADHD, don't have a learning disability, have never been concussed, basically normal kids with normal brains, and they ask them to take the test for research purposes. So we can compare a concussed patient with age-matched norms to see how they compare to other kids their age. The recommendation, of course, is to get a baseline test before the season starts, and then after the injury, then they take another post-injury test anywhere 1 to 3 days after the injury to see how bad they are, see how bad their brain functioning, memory, processing, et cetera, as well as symptom inventory, how that is. And it's recommended every 5 to 7 days during recovery, they come back for another post-injury test to monitor how they're progressing. We're starting to learn, especially the football players, they think they have a way to outsmart us. They're kind of talking amongst themselves. If you do bad on the baseline test, you know, tank the baseline test or bomb it on purpose, get a low score. That way, if you get concussed, you'll be much more likely to reach your baseline. But there's built-in values in the test that we can tell. We can tell whether they actually put in a good effort or not. You know, the pattern of missed answers are going to change whether they got wrong answers on purpose or they really tried and just were unable to do it. So there's ways that we can look at the test and decide whether that baseline test was valid or not. The way the impact test is administered, it's a computer-based test. It's all done from the web, and it lasts about 30 minutes. The first part of the test is the demographic information. You want to know, of course, the name, the age of the child, the sport they play, how long they've been playing the sport. And a very important part of that first section is the past medical history. You want to know if they have other neurologic issues, such as ADHD, learning disabilities, such as dyslexia, mood disorders, or any other neurologic problems, such as seizures, being treated for migraines or meningitis in the past. Another very important part of this is their concussion history, because it's been shown that kids that have had one concussion may have a high risk of suffering a second concussion, and that second and all subsequent injuries may occur with less of a blow, and the symptoms seem to last a little bit longer. So it's important to know whether that child or that athlete has suffered previous concussions or not. Then the second part of the test is the symptom inventory. There's 22 most common symptoms that athletes with concussions get, and the kids are asked to rate those 0 to 6. 0 if that symptom is absent, 1 to 2 if they perceive it as mild, 3 to 4 moderate, and 5 to 6 severe. And they go through each individual symptom to see how symptomatic they are at that time. And we call that the symptom inventory. And then the last part is the actual meat of the test. That's the actual cognitive testing program, which consists of 6 different modules. And each module is designed to check different areas of the brain, how it works, such as visual memory, motor speed, reaction time, processing, the way that the athlete solves problems. And then based on how they perform on those 6 modules, then we're given composite scores, and we can compare them either to their baseline or to their age-matched normative values. The baseline test never was and never will be intended to be a standalone or the single most important determinant of whether an athlete, number one, is concussed, or whether they're deemed return to play. It's the athlete's condition, it's their symptoms, it's how they've done as you slowly return them to academic stress as well as return them to athletic stress. There's a whole process of evaluation, ongoing evaluations of these kids, and the impact test is just one tool. It's one thing that we can use to help us with the answer. So it should never be used as a standalone tool to determine a concussion has occurred or that an athlete's concussion is resolved.